New developments in the push to find a way to treat and assess concussions. It's now a multi-million dollar industry. In the NFL, many athletes are turning to hyperbaric oxygen for relief. But it's an effort that comes with some controversy. Every time Robert McCune steps out of this hyperbaric chamber, he feels healed.
Sometimes I have a bad headache and I get in there, and when I comes out, like, I swear to you, my headache, it's gone.
The retired NFL linebacker for the Ravens is using hyperbaric oxygen to treat headaches and tremors caused by 10 years of repeated concussions.
Man, there's probably been hundreds where I have just blacked out.
McCune is among a growing number of athletes using hyperbaric oxygen as a concussion treatment.
Is it wakes up those cells?
Hall of Famer Joe Namath being one of the biggest names leading the charge. He says the treatments have improved his memory retention.
Literally see the change take place.
Injured body tissue needs increased oxygen to heal. So the hope behind hyperbaric is that pressurized oxygen is restoring brain cells damaged by traumatic brain injuries.
There's so many other players that are out there that are starting to realize the positive, wonderful effects of what hyperbaric is.
Dr. Lewis Hilliard runs the Atlanta Hyperbaric Center out of Smyrna, where McCune gets his treatments.
This is a non-toxic, non-invasive form of treatment that can get sick people well very easily.
Hilliard himself, a former football player, says it's so popular, he created an NFL outreach program that he runs with McCune.
The University of Georgia, their football program just purchased their first hyperbaric chamber for their football program and their players as well.
The NFL reported a 58% increase in concussions last year, 182 cases reported, up from 115 in 2014. But not everyone is convinced it works.
And there's a lot of mishmash of what is actually, you know, just hype and pizzazz versus real science.
Dr. Gerald Zavorsky is a professor at Georgia State University, and he studies concussions. He says while hyperbaric is used to treat burn victims and carbon monoxide poisoning, the science is sketchy when it comes to concussions.
People think that this extra high pressure oxygen allows for more blood to have this oxygen to be carried to the brain. Well, that is not really true.
Part of the problem, he says, is determining whether it's the pressure or the oxygen affecting the damaged brain cells.
In these studies, the high pressured air is thought to be a placebo effect because you're not actually getting any more oxygen to the brain.
And that placebo effect, Zavorsky says, is what may have athletes like McCune believing they feel better, although there's no scientific evidence to support it.
I think as scientists and researchers, we shouldn't take testimonies for granted. It needs to be backed up with research.
Hilliard says the skeptics don't bother him or hurt his business. He's been selling a lot of chambers.
I don't care what people think. What I see, the miracles that happen in my office, and the people that are coming in here with various elements, we don't treat anything. All I do is I just give them a breath from God.
Dr. Zavorsky says there are, by the way, no harmful effects of hyperbaric treatments. However, most hyperbaric treatments, they're not covered by insurance, and they can be costly. At Atlanta Hyperbaric Center, a session costs between $75 and $100 for an hour or two.